Hello everybody, it's Daz Rancher 3. Welcome back to Go Vacation. Hey, that girl in yellow just copied me. And I've got mystical powers because she was behind me and I could still see what was happening. Haha, yeah. Okay, so in the last episode we were in the marine resort. We did loads of ATV racing. Because we had the ATV tricks already done, we unlocked a new trophy for the house. So we're going to check it out by talking to this girl in yellow. Here is where you can remodel your villa. Right, so there's options in here, but we're going to go into decorative items. It should be in under decorative items. Yes, it's glowing new. It's got a pink little new thing on it, so because I've used 100 pieces of furniture in my house, I have to get rid of a chair before I can check. So let's go to the furniture menu and press 2, or 1 even, until we find the... Oh, it's gift wrap. Excuse me. Oh, there it is. Wow, it's got a lightning bolt for some reason. What the hell does that mean? Alright, so there you go. What do you think? Which is the best trophy? ATV and surfing looks pretty much the same. The pedestal is the exact same shape. The trophy starts off with a brown base and it's all gold. They do get a bit different too. No, that's the same. Oh, but it's a picture though. It's not exactly the same as the other ones. That was the one of a gold trophy. This is the weirdest one. We've got a snowman. Just a snowman, like. That's it. Equestrian medal for doing the horseback riding on the mountain resorts. So there are kind of pictures as well. So still quite a few to go here in gift wrap. Still a few question marks going around the place. All right, let's copy our chair. And our house is complete. Let's get out of here. Let's go to the villa grounds. So in this episode, I'm at a loss. Which resort will I go to? I don't know. I really don't. I might go back to the mountain resort. Earn silver or gold keys by clearing activities. No, I'm going to go back to the marine resort. I want to go back to the marine resort. Marine resort is probably my favorite resort out of a lot of them. So let's go to the marine resort. There's a couple of pictures I could take that I still haven't found. Well, I got my picture taken in the last episode, if you didn't see it. And hopefully that gets taken away from the total of 7 pictures. I think I took 4. With that one, hopefully it says 5 of 7. Anyway, welcome here, good transfer between resorts. Would you like to visit another resort? We're going to go to the marine resort. And it's, of course, the daytime again. Alright, so there's not too many activities left on the marine resort, but we've got a quest to do where there's an old guy who wants us to find stuff. We might do that in this episode. Welcome to the marine resort, Daz Rancher 3. You found all the treasure. Ah, it's still 4 out of 7 photos. Bye for now, music note. Right, so in this episode, I'm going to change my clothes. I like my shirt, but it's time for a change. Where the hell are you going? Pirate lady.
Welcome,
here is where you can get changed. Right, let's see what's on offer. Let's see if we can wear something pretty decent, because in the last couple episodes, I've been wearing tongs, clown suits, Santa outfits. Let's put on something a little bit respectable, alright? Let's dress as if we were actually on vacation. Stars? I don't like the pants. What are they stitched up at the side with, like X's? does it get any better with different colours? Wow. Right. Oh, was I wearing this shirt before? Oh, what number is purple again? Number 6. Number 5. Yeah, we'll wear that. Screw it. Something different. And the pants is like checkered. That's kind of weird. But anyway, change the shoes. The shoes are gonna go. I'm going barefoot. And no gloves. That's cool. If I was on a beach, the only thing I would wear is sandals. Because if you've ever been on holidays, when it's really sunny out and it's really hot, the sand will burn your feet. It's that hot on the sand. It's crazy. What a marvelous ensemble. You'll be dancing in the shade all the time to try and cool down your feet. But then again, I guess people who live in that kind of climate, their feet are used to that kind of heat, perhaps. Is that true? Anyone live in a hot country? Do you go barefoot in the sand all the time? Being in Ireland, I'm from Ireland. We get mostly rain. We don't go to the beach because we don't get the weather. We do sometimes. In the summer, funny that. Okay, Mystic Jungle, where are we going? Oh yeah, up here. Oh, excuse me! We don't necessarily be dancing on sand and stuff, but over in hot countries, I'd love to know if it's hot over there, do you still dance on the sand? Does your feet still get sore? What's the story? Do you get used to it at all? I find that interesting now. Interesting. Interesting little topic, I guess. Right, Mystic Jungle. Let me up here. Oh, this shirt is amazing. It's amazing on me. M-I-I. Hooray! Hey, we'll get the balloon while we're here. Let's do a forward tumble to get the balloon. Oh, yeah. Pick up this message balloon. Yes, let's see what it says. Scuba diving. Fish sighting 5. Near Rocky Ridge Cove's mermaid, you can spy a mother, Bulga, and her calf. They say the calf is a slightly different color from its mother. Wow. I remember seeing a whale before, but... it's calf? Oh, sorry, lizard. Freak. What the hell am I doing? How do I get to the friggin'... it's back here. Ah, yes, here we are. What does that sign actually say? Let's have a look. Wild Hills, forward up the hill. Mystic Jungle, this way. Where the red bush is. Ah, nothing like a red bush. Oh, God. Right. So, if you didn't know, we're going to this temple. It should be up this way. Yeah, it's closer to the waterfall. Whoa! We have to go towards the waterfall. The temple should be up here on our right. I do believe it's just here. Ah, pull the brakes, goddammit. This old guy with the shaky... oh, no, it's not a shaky hand. What are they talking about? Hey, he's wearing my shirt. He's got a red bush in his head. Right. How are you doing, sir? Yeah, about time. There you go. Wahaha! Right. You and I are friends, right? So you'll keep finding my keepsakes. Okay. Basically, this guy is asking us to find his mementos, and we've found 2 of them so far. He has a total of 5 he wants retrieved for him, so we're going to go to stage number 3. We're going to be told about it. It's find the shiny gold statue. Int. I remember it being near a cabin in a small, dark place. I'm pretty sure there was a sunken ship nearby. Good luck. So, instantaneously, I think back to a previous episode. I'm actually going to go on to a... oh, what? Let me go on a marine bike. Okay, there's a cave with a sunken ship in it. And there's also a dark cabin, as he said. And he said that the treasure should be around there. It's not easy to find him. If you're in the vicinity, you get that yellow icon above it. It's like you're going talking to him. That yellow icon will be there, so... okay, how do we get to this sunken treasure? Whoa. Let's go up here and see. Is this the way? Am I going? Yeah, this is the way. No, I am not going swimming. Although, that could get me the challenge. Alright, let's see. Well, I don't know. I don't know. It's going to take me forever and a day to swim all that way. Oh, I hear a car humming or something. Ooh, it's a boat. Wait up for B boat. Come on, Yoshi. Let's go for a little paddle. Right, so let's quickly check here. View records. Okay, that's the marine resort. We've only got 1, 2, 3 games left to go. We've got marine bike races. What? I did that. Why does it do that? I did marine bike race. Oh, marine bike races, not ATV, you stupid idiot. Okay, marine bike races, beach volleyball, and scuba diving. Right, okay. Now, we're going to check something else over here. We're not checking the activity records for silver keys. We're checking the challenge records. Marine Resort Master swam over 6,000 feet, not done. And that is for a gold key, so this is... a pretty worthwhile one. So we can actually check here. Ah, Alicia32 is my best friend. And my favorite resort is a snow resort. That is not true, but I must have been there the most. Will it tell me how much I've swam? I've 1,689 feet swam. Oh, okay. Let's go for a swim, Yoshi. Now look at Yoshi. Look at the way he swims. He just kicks out one of his legs at a time. That is freaking adorable. Right, so is it this way or that way? It's this way. Come on, Yoshi. Swim with me, boy. So I think if I swim If I just swim normally here with my arms and legs, right? And if I get to the treasure, The minute I find this golden shiny statue for this guy, I get warped right back to the temple where he is, so that ain't a bad thing. If I had to swim in here, retrieve the statue, and then swim all the way out, we're looking at an hour-long episode, everybody. And that just wouldn't do. Right, we're hearing that weird cave sound again. Is there any sunken ship nearby? Oh, there's loads of bats here. We have to go a bit deeper into the cavern. There's a dark cabin just to the left over here, just around the corner, I presume. I'm not quite sure. I haven't been in here all that often. I know I was in here in one of the earlier episodes trying to discover around the sunken ship and stuff, but well, we will have a look and see. See a little torch up there in the rock? Little torch? Maybe you can come in here at... Oh, well, you can't come here at night time. You can come here in the evening. You should be able to go to every resort at every time of day. Dusk, dawn, evening, night, day. They should probably do, like, you know, if you go to a resort, it should be daytime and it should progressively go to nighttime. Kind of like the Ocarina of Time when you're in Hyrule Field. What do you think? Do you think that'd be a good idea if the time changed while you were there as opposed to going somewhere at nighttime? And, you know, I don't really notice the difference between nighttime and daytime. The same things happen. The same people are in the exact same place. I don't know why you'd have to go at nighttime. You know, it's not like in Animal Crossing where you can only catch a certain type of bug at nighttime. You know? What am I doing? Alright, here we go. Yes, here we are! Yay! We made it! Oh, wow, cool. Cool. So, whoa, what a weird face. Alright, let's read about this really quickly. You found the old man's memento. Shiny gold statue. Good boy. Whoa! I'm here at the temple. Waha! The way the light reflects off this takes me back 50 years. This gold statue represents everything I love about my wife. Oh, he's married, man. I had it specially made for her. We'd gotten into a quarrel about something stupid, so I gave her this gift to make it up for her. To make it up to her. A shiny gold statue of my wife. Whoa, she's really short. But all she said was, "This is terrible, you have horrible taste," and threw the statue away. Then she stormed out of the house. Now that I think about it, she was probably just shy. After about 3 days, she finally came back, but I never saw the statue again. I know, maybe I should try giving it to my wife again. Oh, but I guess if I do that, she might storm out of the house again. Well, in that case, I will just keep it with me at all times. Thanks again for your help. Until next time, wahaha. Cool. Thanks, old man. I guess he did kind of help me get my swimming up. Hey, get off, Yoshi. Right. Oh, is he pushing my ATV? Let's get back. Look. Freaking dog. He's a nuisance. He's a nuisance. Whoa. All right. Can I swim in here? Let me swim in this water. No, it doesn't count. That does not count. Alright, we're going to talk to him again, but I just, for pig iron, I want to see how much that swimming counted. Let's see, Marine Resort Master Swam over 6,000 feet. Alright, let's see. Oh, I'm on 3,250. I've still got more distance to swim. That was probably the best opportunity I had to swim a bit, but anyhow. We've already read all this before, so there's no point in going through it again, but let's see what else he wants us to find. Right, stage number 4. Hopefully there's not much... Oh, hang on. Find the sea serpent's fang. Hint. Only thing I remember is that it is near lots of falling water. Good luck. Okay, falling water. That's the waterfall in the Mystic Jungle where I am right now, so... That's kind of odd. Anyhow. That's just up here to the right. Isn't it? Yes, it is. Woohoo! Yeah, so anyway, I think coming to this resort and it changing from day to night and evening and all the rest of it, I think that'd be really cool. Yeah, you can already see it up there. I just saw it. I got a glint of it in the top left corner of my screen. It's just around the corner. Whoa. That wasn't good. What the hell is that? Let's have a look at it before we pick it up. Is it just a snake? Oh no, it's a serpent fang. That's what he said. Find! You found the old man's memento, sea serpent's fang. Heh! Just holding this takes me back 40 years. That was when I still fancied myself an adventurer. And I got this fang during a life or death battle with a legendary sea serpent. Wow. They say a sea serpent's fang will bring you good luck. I wanted one so badly that I battled him with nothing but my trusty harpoon. Sure, he bit my backside, but at least I got that fang. After that, my life was perfect. If I ordered regular coffee, the store clerk would add whipped cream on top, free of charge. And I even found a four-leaf clover. But one day, I ate my wife's favorite sweets by mistake. In revenge, she threw away my serpent's fang. Since then, I've had horrible luck, falling into holes, stepping in dog poo. It just never stops. I can't believe he actually says that. Wahaha! But thank you. Thanks to you, I've got my fang back. I can't thank you enough. Happy days are here again. Until next time. Crazy old man. Right. Let's talk to him one last time to find the last piece, and hopefully that person... What's he shouting at? Hey, everybody, I'm trapped in a video game. Wahaha! I knew he'd be coming. Yeah. Oh, I think he says different things. Stage number 5. Let's see what he's looking for this time. Find the ancient king's scepter. Hint. I think it was somewhere near a stone statue of some creature. Some place without a lot of wiggle room. Good luck. I think it was somewhere near a stone statue. I don't remember seeing any stone statues. Wahaha! Thanks again for your help. A stone statue. Okay, well... I know there's a second temple here with like a dolphin outside it. The only other place I can think of a stone statue of a creature is the fountain where the ATV races is. So let's have a quick look up here. Whoa. Ah, this is it. There it is. That's the dolphin. When it said creature, I was thinking more so like, you know, some sort of a weird creature as opposed to an actual dolphin. What the hell is that stuff? Okay. Weird. Is that from a game or something? Anyone recognize what this could be from? Usually Namco, they have their little references to different games, like Pac-Man's all over this game. Don't know what that is. Is that from a different game? Let me know in the comment section. I'd love to know. Right. You found the old man's memento, Ancient King's Scepter. My, holding this takes me back some 30 years. This is the very scepter the ruler of this island wielded long, long ago. They say if you wave this scepter and say the magic words, your wish will come true. I found it at the ruins in the jungle 30 years ago. But then, one day, a bird pooped on my head. What's his story with poop like? I was so upset, I threw the scepter, which I happened to have with me at the time. Which, what? I threw the scepter? Okay, whatever. To have with me at the time, right at the bird. Of course, I missed, and I had no idea where the scepter landed. Alright, I get you. Anyway, it's time to use the scepter to cast a spell. Now, let's see. What were the magic words again? Oh, that's right. Adnab Ockman. Drat. Not enough magic power. Wahaha. Well, it's still worth holding on to. That's all that matters, right? Thanks again for finding it. Until next time. Now, do we get a villa like that person said in the comment section? Let's see. Hey, nice one. Obtained villa type Oriental. Dazran 303 has found all keepsakes and received Grandpa's thanks. More items now available at remodeling in the villa grounds. So thanks very much to the person who commented. I can't remember the username, but hopefully you know who you are. And I say to you, thank you very much. It's always appreciated when people leave comments in the comment section. Especially informative comments such as the one you were leaving. Thank you very much. It's great. Okay, so we've got a couple of minutes left to go. Let's see if we can... maybe nip down to the beach for a quick game of beach volleyball. Will I have enough time for that? I'm not really sure. Oh, driving through bushes. Oh, holy crap. Ah. Yoshi's just standing there going, yeah, not going down there. Fool. Let's pull the brakes. Boop. Now, view records. Let's see what games we have available. Beach volleyball, scuba diving, or marine bike races. Well, maybe marine bike races would be better. We're going to have to make our way down to the marina. So anywhere we can turn right here, we can go and have some good times and play the marine bikes for a little bit. And we have to go back to the lady in blue. Okay, let's see if we can scale this rock here. Woohoo! Holy crap. Oh, that's what an ATV quad bike's all about. Oh, holy god. Holy crap. Double front flip. just in time to bounce off the floor. Oh! Oh no, don't tell me we're not going the right way. Is this going to be in water? Hopefully not. Oh.
Oh!
Damn it.
God damn it.
Oh, that was close again. Alright, there must be a turn off here to the left. Yes, I see one. There's like a viewing area just here, up here to the left. Where we can launch ourselves at the marina. Ha ha! Well, the marina isn't over here, but you know what I'm saying. There's like a tent over here for orchestras or something. Woo! So long!
Beep beep.
There's a restaurant that you can't enter. There's another building that you can't enter or interact with at all. It's a real shame. I've said it in previous episodes, you guys already know the story. But I just love if we could do some more stuff with the buildings that are here, as opposed to them just being solid blocks of stuff. Oh, yeah! Aren't these pecs of mine incredible? What the hell? Alright, let's see. Let's see what we have to do to complete the marine bike activity. Oh, I hate when it does this. Oh, I'm at marine bike tricks. Oh. Man, I always do this. I always get myself into a pickle looking for the games that I want, assuming they're in a certain place, and then getting it wrong. Haha! What's the problem? Were my glutes too much for you to take? Come see me again. Oh dear. Right, let's get a marine bike so we can easily find it, because obviously the marine bike activity is going to be in water. Sorry, Yoshi, you're going to have to swim all the way. Your little paws aren't going to carry you as far as my marine bike will, or as fast even. Alright, you can go under the water with this marine bike, is it? Oh, you have to hold forward on the nunchuck. Let's see. See if we can do it now. Woohoo! Hey! I don't actually think you can do that in real life, but anyway. Right, where is this marine bike races? Map. There's a sea. It's over here. Right, it's towards the edge of this island, so we're going in the right direction. Let's keep going down here. This is the way. This is the way, let's go. Such a beautiful island, Kauai Island. I just wish you could do, like if there was an airstrip and you could do something like Wii Sports Resort Island flyover and stuff. They should have a plane that you can control. As opposed to just being sitting in the plane looking out the window. I want to fly, damn it. But we'll settle for marine bikes. Which is what we're going to do now. Silver keys, what do we have to do? Okay, we've got the sprint race, circuit race, and the hoop challenge. What the hell? It's that activity. Let's go into the hoop challenge. It's 5 stages. Okay, let's see how long stage 1 takes. We are now going for a hoop challenge. Feel free to post video responses at the miserable scores that I will certainly achieve. Okay, 1 minute and 35. All right, this will be good. Bit like wave race. Oh, what a shot. Keep that nice and tight. Alright, not doing too bad. I think I'm on for a stellar score here. Oh, the waves are getting choppy. There's one over here. It's on the other side of the barrier. Desperate cheer tree making mistakes for days. Freaking stupid. Thinking the game was trying to be better than it was. Oh, that was a good time I was having. I was having a good time. Why would they have those rings on the other side of the barrier? That's just silly. And he fails with the double front flip, but you know what? Screw it. He deserved it. Okay, I think we've got time for another couple of hoop challenges before we leave. Activity screen. So see if you can beat 55 seconds flat. Pretty nice rounded off number there. Start activity. Hoop challenge. Stage number 2. The challenge is not to fall for the hoops on the other side of the barrier, I tell you. That is the challenge. Yeah! Who fell for the hoop on the other side of the barrier? This guy! Sticking his thumb at himself. Alright, you won't catch me up this time, game. I'm all about you. I know your tricks. Alright, this is going to be a stellar time. Nobody's going to be able to beat this time in a video response. Oh, water's getting choppy. I didn't even jump there. Oh, you have to jump here. Woohoo! Fantastic time. Is there any rings on other sides of barriers anywhere? Woohoo! That is all the rings got in 53 seconds. 03! 303! What the hell? What are the chances? 53:03. That is my time. If I've ever seen it before in my life. Alright, let's do one more. That is quite enjoyable. Look at that. 53:03. I love it. Love it, man. Freaking love it. Stat activity. Hoop challenge number 3. We'll be definitely coming back to the Marine Resort for this. This is fun. And I hope you guys are eager to get your video responses in for this hoop challenge. I actually enjoy this. I think I'm pretty okay at it. I did the... I started off with the City Resort grinding... Grindmaster, I think it was called, actually. Skating Grindmaster. And got some responses. Looking for some responses on my... Did I miss it? No, I didn't. Looking for some responses on my ATV racing. Oh, I'm gonna have to go through here. And this. And future episodes when I do some more of this, it'd be great to see people taking part on trying to beat my scores. Not really too bad, but when it's your first time playing it, you're kind of like, whoa, where the hell am I going now? What am I supposed to be doing? Yeah, I've never done this before, so. These are all my first attempts, first time tries. But I think the times are respectable enough to give you a tiny bit of a challenge, perhaps. Maybe some of you go vacationers out there are hardened hoopers. You'll be able to kick the hoop out of this time. Alright. Half hoops. Whoa, look at the size of that hoop. Woo! I wonder when we start getting hoops that are under the water. Oh! No! No! It's one under the water. Ah, no, that was a good time. That was a good time. I don't like when that happens. Oh, well. Stage number 1 was promising, up until I fell for that hoop on the other side of the barrier. Stage 2 was my best so far. And stage 3 in the last stretch was a disaster. Was an absolute disaster. I'm really... disheartened now by my performance. But anyway, gives you a chance to beat me. Not bad, but you could still be faster. Yeah, I certainly could, man. Right, so let's go back over to Lily and Co. to end this episode. Unfortunately, we didn't get our picture taken. Didn't see any picture spots. Did you guys see any picture spots here? Just did a big 360 panoramic view of the island. Is there a picture over here, no? Nope. Sunshine Beach. Must keep our eye out for more pictures as we drive along. I probably passed out some, but, you know, concentrating on trying to find things like shiny gold statues that the wife has thrown away on this old man. There's a picture. No, I'm not going to go for it. I'm not going to... Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, no! No, I'm going to appear somewhere. I hate when that happens. Oh, that's very good. Oh, Mac, I'm sorry. I just... broke your boat. I mean, that's not a boat, that's a plane. Now let's get this beach ball back to the lady in blue and see what she thinks. See what she thinks about it. Here is my gift to you, lady. Now I can jump on your face. Ugh. Oh, what? Let's try and stay on it, actually, just for a couple of... Oh. Guys, what the hell? Put on some clothes. Jeez. Welcome! Hello. Here you can transfer between resorts. Would you like to visit another resort? We are going home, Lady in Blue. We have had a very memorable day here, looking after some old man things. And did some hoop racing. Well, we are back, everybody. Who the hell is this? Oh, is she like... She's wearing a space suit. Hey, how cool is that? Alright, let's stand on her head. Right, so thanks, everybody. What am I looking at? I'm looking at you guys. Thanks, everybody, for coming out to watch Go Vacation. I hope you enjoyed the episode. We got a new villa resort. Or we got a new villa, I should say. We've got a couple of gold keys left, I hope. Maybe I'll try and unlock some more villas, show you guys all the villas that are on offer in future episodes. That is it from me. I hope you enjoyed the episode, and I'm going to see you. Where are you? I can't see you guys. Where the hell did you go? Come back. I'm going to see you in some more future episodes of Go Vacation Let's Play. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching my video. If you enjoyed it, you can subscribe here for more videos. If you want to see some more videos from me, you can click on the videos playing on screen. Or if you want to check out my Let's Play channel and vlog channel, there's links down below.